It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, the Managing Director and Chief Investment Strategist at Payne Capital Management. Stocks rose on the week to a five-week high as investors put trade concerns on the back burner as the banks kicked off what many believe will be an excellent quarter for earnings. Shares of tech companies led the market higher, with the NASDAQ index, the small company growth index, large company growth index, and the mid company growth index all touching or exceeding all-time highs in price. Overall, profit results are expected to build on the strong first quarter, and analysts expect 20% year-over-year gains over the next four quarters. That's about as healthy as a stock market gets, and if earnings come in anywhere near these estimates, it's going to be very difficult to see stock prices fall. Remember, stocks are the slaves of earnings. And one of the most widely watched indicators, the P/E ratio, that's calculated by dividing the current price, P, by its earnings per share, E, and there's no P without E. And it looks like earnings are going to be much higher. The economy also got a fresh sign that inflation is moving higher. The consumer price index, which gauges the prices you pay on most goods, rose 2.9% from last year. This is the highest level since February of 2012. The latest reading puts inflation closer to where Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell wants it and confirms his observation that the U.S. economy, quote, is in a really good place, unquote. Now, historically, the third quarter is the worst quarter for the stock market in any year. But what happens when the S&P 500 is higher in April, in May, in June, like it was this year in 2018? How about the third quarter has been higher 9 of the last 10 times? So for now, let's ignore the noise and stay invested.